got an opportunity to invest in what? पूछा नहीं, हम लोग भी थोड़ा पढ़ लेते हैं रूडी जी. And how many trusts have got or how many people have invested in SEZ from the 2nd of March till now? Because after you've got the order, if you could kindly clarify. Thank you, ma'am, for the
Jayadev Galla ji.
Thank you.
Jayadev ji, 3 minutes. Very brief and just pointed.
Madam, I'm not going to waste any time talking about the ordinance, and I'm not going to waste any time talking about the bill, because all the comments have already been made. But I would like to take some time to touch upon some of the issues relating to SEZ in this country and make some suggestions which I think will be valuable input. Madam, the real objectives behind the SEZs are being diluted. SEZs have become land banks for people today. So I strongly feel while giving land for SEZs, there should be commitment in terms of how many jobs at different scales and different education levels are going to be created. That commitment must be taken up front, madam. Also, madam, along with job creation commitments, a requirement for industries to set up skill development centers to train local people and to increase local employment should also be made mandatory, madam. Madam, also we have to look at how much tax revenue is going to be generated by these SEZs. There should be conditions for this also while giving out the land for SEZs. If all these commitments are fulfilled, then government giving land at even minimum price, even for developers, is definitely worthwhile, madam. I'm saying this because employment opportunities created and revenue generated will stimulate the local economy and improve, as our Prime Minister rightly said, the ease of living for everyone in this country, madam. Wealth so created will make up for the subsidized land. Now, this is the theory behind SEZ, and there are many shining examples of successful SEZs in this country. But at the same time, there are even many more failures where land is kept idle and is not being put to productive use, where intent of the developers is suspect as they sit on these land blocks with ulterior motives. So we have to see how to create a policy that encourages the former and discourages the latter, madam. Madam, one of the biggest pain points in setting up SEZs, as many people have already mentioned, is land acquisition, madam. Landowners whose land is acquired get less than the market price generally, the actual market price, not the official price, and the neighbors' value increases. The people whose land is left outside the border of the SEZ, their land price escalates in terms of price. So the original landowners feel a double whammy. Their land has been taken away at below market prices, while their neighbor's land is escalating, upsetting the entire social equation in that area as well. So one idea I think which we can definitely consider here to avoid this type of escalation and ill feelings among the people whose land is being acquired is the idea of land pooling, madam. Land pooling was something that we've done very effectively in Amaravati.